website is concerned, which is a test design. And who are going to work on this test design? Senior test engineers. And what are they going to do? Test, write the test scenarios. Like, what is the scenario you have to come up with, and write the stories, and also elaborate them into test cases. So I showed in the last class, right? What is the sample test cases would look like, and in the step-by-step manner with the step number, description, expected result, actual result, and stuff like that. So what is a test scenario? Test scenario is nothing but a test case title or story in one sentence, right? That's what I showed you. It should say everything, like there is a family of three members, husband, wife, and kid, with so and so ages, having so and so income, are applying for healthcare. Okay, then they would get so and so benefit from healthcare. They will, that's a whole story in one single sentence. Now, test case is, you have to divide this scenario into step-by-step manner. Like, okay, first you go to the URL, okay? Launch the URL in the browser. Expected result is application is launched. Then you log in with valid user ID password, second step. Then expected result is login is should be successful. Actual result you are going to write at the time of execution. Actual result will be, yes, login is successful. And then you apply for this benefit. Then benefit is applied. Benefit should be applied successfully. And actual would be benefit is successful. If it is not successful, benefit is not coming. Then you raise a defect. So that test case would be totally elaborative. So in step-by-step manner, even if a novice will look at it, they should be able to understand it. Okay, so this is the business requirements, right? Let's say login should only be successful with a valid user ID of min 6, max 30 alphanumeric characters and a password which is valid. Let's say that is the requirement. Now you have to write a test scenario as a test. So pay attention. How do you write? User login should only be successful with the user ID if minimum 6 and maximum 30 characters with alphanumeric password which is valid is provided, right? Okay. So you have to do your black BVA and DCP. So you know, min minus 1, min plus 1, max minus 1, max plus 1, and that would have be having two negative scenarios and four positive scenarios, and equivalence class partition you would do, okay, like this. BVA and minimum 4, if you take it will go to the next page. When I say next page, that means successful, and minimum minus 1, 3, it would be error message, okay, it would be providing error message, that is a negative scenario. And this is positive, negative. So if you follow BVA, it would automatically cover positive and negative test case. You don't have to worry. It will have four positive and two negative every time. Same thing. Okay. I'm going too fast. Okay. So test scenario. This is what I have given for you to write test cases. Did anyone feel right? This is for one positive, one negative. Verify that if user ID is four alphanumeric cases and password as four alphanumeric entered, then the next page should be displayed. That is a positive. And one for negative, verify if a user ID is four alpha in lower cases and password has three alpha submitted, then the same page with an error message, because this is not adhering to the rule requirement. Remember, requirement is given in the previous section. So you have to write the two test cases. Obviously, test cases would contain elaborated fashion. So you go to the application, log in with these, and what happens? Expected result. So it would contain three or four steps. That's it. So did anybody write? Anybody write and put them into that folder I gave you, homework? Anybody?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay, so one person has done the homework. What about the others?
I'm still working on it, so I'm sorry.
Okay, no problem. So whenever you're done, just put them in this homework folder. Just drop them. Okay, you have the access to this. I given to everyone. For the new people, you can send me an email. I'll include you in the access list. Okay, so just drag and drop the files with underscore your name, homework underscore your name. Yeah. Oh, somebody has created a folder. So Mom Mozamel Haq. You don't have to create a folder. That's okay. Folder is fine, but make sure you name them proper. Okay, nothing is inside, just a folder. That's okay. Okay. Anyway, don't worry. Okay, so your test case it doesn't have to have all this, like, but you can just follow the template, the Excel spreadsheet I gave you. You can just follow that. Okay, so just follow the same, take it and modify it according to your homework, whatever is homework. So this is a data pool for automation. Don't worry about it. This is a test plan, and I think somebody has put their own test plans. That's okay. You can look at them. Probably they are something else. Data full for automation test cases and regression test template. This is the test case document. Okay. So you download this and put your own test cases. Yeah, yeah, go on.
Yeah, the automation test plan PDF you put it in there. We have access to download that one. I was trying to download it and it's access denied.
Russell, right?
No, Faisal.
Oh, Faisal. Yeah, just right click and download. So there is the download
option. Giving me access denied every time.
Okay, whatever email you have to log in with the same email, because if you log in with other email, it will say access denied, right? So tell me your email. I'll just include you. What is the email? Okay, so this is a folder, right? Now I gave some sharing option to some only I think 18 students or so, but you have to log in with the same email ID, then only you will be able to access them. Okay, so yeah, Faisal, tell me your email. I'll add that email to you so that you can also access it.
Yeah, my email address is already in there. I look at it.
Okay, yeah. So there are your email address is already in this 29.
Yeah, MASUM29. That should be 28. Don't know what 29.
MA?
No, like first letter is F.
Okay, yep.
MASUM.
That one. It's already there.
Yeah.
Okay, let me add it again, because so like I said, you have to be logged into Gmail or Google Drive with the same email ID, otherwise you will get access denied error. That is the whole point, right? So do that. I think you should get it. Just log out from the other accounts. You may have multiple accounts, right? So yeah, that's common. I encountered that issue, but just log out from others and you will get it. Okay, anyway, so just access this document for the testing purposes, because you will be given some task in the lab session also. Probably you are given in today's or tomorrow's. So test case document, this has this exact template with these headers: step number, test description, expected result, actual result, test data, and wording. So in this case, you have to fill step number one, test description, what you have to do, you know, go to the login page and enter the password. Then what should happen? What you think should happen? Login should be successful if it is a positive test case. If it is a negative, if you provide invalid credentials, login should be failed. Okay, so likewise you write all the steps. That is nothing but
this is Manohar. I joined today. Can you update my email ID? It's manu4239@yahoo.com.
Okay, so let me add. I think there are two people joined today, right? That's why I'm recapping. Were you able to understand this class? Mano, right?
Yes, MANU 4239 at yahoo.com.
Oh, yahoo.com. Okay, so yahoo.com, you will get the link. Don't worry, I'll share the link. But if you have Gmail, you can use it login. Anyone else? Join today?
Hey, this is Shruti. Can you add me, please?
Yeah, so tell me, Shruti, what is your email?
KCP 2910 at gmail.com.
At gmail, okay. So did you guys understand today's class? I recap. So only 2-3 sessions were over. So I'll just. Yeah.
My name is Sapna. SAPNA.
Sapna SAPNA.
1884. At Gmail. Thank you.
So okay, Sapna, Manu, and KCP. Were you able to join? Were you able to understand today's class? It's a first class for you, right? I believe.
Yeah.
Okay. So this I will share this link notes also with you. You can go through them. It's pretty easy because these are very basic concepts. Going forward, it will get tough. But since there are two classes which are already over, I just recapitulated everything for you guys.
And also, we have notes of last two classes. Thank you.
Right, no problem. So you go through this. I'll share the link again to you guys. Okay, I'll just copy your.
This is to you. Can you add me?
Okay. Tell me yours.
Shafiq Tuhin, SAFIQTUHIN.
SAFI.
Q.
Q.
F. Sorry, F S A F I Q.
U.
Q. Yeah.
Q.
Yeah. T U then T U. U. U as an umbrella. Yeah. H.
H.
Yeah. I N. At gmail.com.
Okay, is it correct?
Yes.
Shafiq Tuhin at gmail.com, right?
Yes, thank you.
Okay. Okay, so only 4 people joined today. Anyone else?
So we can get the email notification, right? Then we have to click and sign in with the email address, right?
So I'm going to send it. You are going to get the email with this Google Drive link immediately. Okay, check it and let me.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay, did you get right now? Just now? Okay, anyway, Asadi is going to send. And a new email with your emails included. So I'm going to reply to that email with this link and the notes so that everybody can get this link. So even if I miss someone, you can get it. Okay, so examples, you go through this again. Whoever has not done the homework, please do it because this is important. All you got to do is just write one test case for the happy path and one test case for the negative path. And you already have the documents. The document you have to follow for writing test case is the last document, this one, the star. Okay, I started it actually. I added a star for this. It's called test case document. You download it and according to your test case, you just modify it and put it in the homework folder. Okay, so it will have these headers. All you have to fill is step number one, test description, what you have to do, and what you're expecting. Okay, and leave this actual result and test data because those are for the execution. So okay, one more example. Okay, after completing you can also complete, but I'm not sure if you're able to complete that. So if you're whoever is completed, you can do this. So this is like this. This is the functional specification or use case. So in an insurance page, user selects policy types. Okay. If user selects policy A, then age object is focused. And age object only takes 16 to 80 characters, not included, greater than 16, but less than 80, and in between. Only upon entering a valid age, submit button is enabled. Okay. That is the requirement. Now you have to write the test case. So BVA is, what is the range? So greater than 16 is 16 is not included. So 17 is the minimum. Okay. Minimum is 17. Pass, because it's pass scenario, minimum if you cover. And minimum minus one is 16. Obviously, if you take less than 16, greater than, if you don't take greater than 16, even if you take 16, it would be fail. Minimum plus one, 17 plus one, 18 is pass scenario. So you got one positive, two, one negative, one positive test case. Again, max is 79 because 80 is not included, strictly less than, right? So maximum is 79, pass. Max minus one, 79 minus one, 78, pass. Max plus one is 80, pass, because it should be less than 80, not equal to 8. So obviously it has to fail. So write the test cases for this. That's all. Prepare all test scenarios and write test cases for a few, not all of them. Okay. And one test scenario, I am writing it for you. This is how it would look like. You just provide the same thing in the Excel spreadsheet. That's all. Verify if policy A is selected from policy dropdown, age object should be focused. When age is entered as 18, submit. Okay, I think you guys are not able to catch what I'm talking about, right? So let's go and check the, I'll show you the diagram. So that's why it is a use case. Use case has a diagram too. Otherwise, it's very difficult to comprehend what the requirement is. So it's not there. No, it's not there. It's actually okay, so let me open it. It's not opening. What is wrong with this? Okay, so just imagine there is a drop down. It's very difficult to imagine, but just try. Okay, it's open. Oh God, this is too slow. Okay. So anyway, this doesn't have it, but I'll write it down. Verify policy is selected. So imagine there is a drop down like this. Okay, don't worry about this. I'll open new diagram. Okay. Okay, so this is a drop down, and this is, let's say there are a couple of policies, policy A, policy B, policy C. Now you have to select policy A from this drop down, and imagine there is an age object here. Okay, so this is called age. Okay, and there is a submit button. Okay, so what happens is, what the requirement is saying is, if policy A is selected from policy dropdown, okay, there are policy B, policy C, so and so, and age object should be focused, right? Focus means it will be the cursor will blink like this in the age object, and there is a text box here, then you enter 18. Okay, then submit button will be enabled. That means you can click on it once it's enabled. If it is not enabled, you cannot click on it. Okay, that is a test case, and you have to write the test steps for this one. Test scenario, you have to write the test steps. That means you have to write actual test case. Okay, now this is how it would look like. So do use the Excel spreadsheet for writing this, because obviously you cannot write test case in Notepad, right? So you do that same thing. You just copy paste from here and put it in there. So then you write your own test case for the other test scenarios. So first step should be open the application. In any of the applications, it's any of the projects is the same thing. First open the application. Then expected result is application should be open, right? Then actual result is, when you are executing, actual result is application is opened or not open, whatever. It's not open, it's a defect. It's open, it's fine. Then verify the policy type drop down. That is the second step. And age text box and submit button should be displayed. At least for the first thing, you have to verify their existence. That means displayed. Okay. Then third step is verify the policy type. Okay. And expected result should be, when you verify policy type, what you are expecting, policy type should have all the values, policy A, policy B, policy, right? Just imagine there is a drop down, drop it down, and you will see all the three values. And verify the age object. Age text box should be fillable and enabled. Okay, then verify submit button, and for the first time, submit button should be disabled, because you have not entered anything in the age object, right? And you have not selected anything in the policy A. Now you are going to come to the selection. Select the policy A. As soon as policy A is selected, what should happen according to the requirement? Age object should be focused, right? Then actually age object is focused at the time of execution. So I have written for that one also, and result would pass. You have to fill that at the execution point, not right here, not yet. Then enter age 18. This is where you're going to apply on the age BBA and ECP. All right. So 18 is the minimum. Submit button should be enabled. Okay. When you enter 18 here, submit button should be enabled. That's your expected result. So you have to specify it explicitly. You have to write it. And enter age, minimum, maximum. Okay. So I'm following the BBA here. Submit button should be disabled, because it's going beyond the range if you enter 9 here, right? So you have to cover that too, and cover one more, 16, disabled, because it's less than 18. Enter age 80, it should be disabled. Okay, so they enter age 59, submit button should be enabled, because it's less than 18. And then, because submit button is enabled, click the submit button. That is your last step, and obviously the expected should be, the next page should be displayed. You are going to go to next page. That is the end of the test case. Okay, so you are going to repeat these steps for the policy B and policy A also. First you started with policy A, so do the same thing for policy B and C. So for repetition, you just mention a note. You don't have to repeat all the steps. That would be too cumbersome, right? And what happens if any of these fail, then verdict should be failed. If all of them passed, verdict should be failed. Because 80 we already provided, right? 80 are some negative test cases, submit button should be disabled. And okay, so that is the expected test case. And let's say submit button is enabled for 80. Okay, developer has written the code little bit wrongly, let's say. And you are expecting is pass here. For age 80, button should be disabled. But it is enabled actually, then it is not meeting. Actually, it's not meeting expected. Submit button should be disabled according to your expectation, but in at the time of execution, submit button is enabled. Disabled versus enabled, both are not equal. Boom, fail. If any of the steps fail, total step test cases fail. If submit button is enabled, submit button is disabled, then this is pass. Okay, so then obviously the all provided all steps have passed, then you would term the whole test step test case result as passed. Okay, so in case of failure, raise a defect like this. In case of failure only. Okay, now immediately you will have to execute these steps, right? Execute them, whatever you have written, written the test steps, you have to execute on the application, right? You can go to any other application, web application. This is just an example. Don't worry. In the lab, you will see. You can go to Walmart application, walmart.com, or different application, kayak.com, and just write any test cases, okay? And you will be able to actually, or just sign up for Google. That would be important, easier for you. Okay, so after this execution, you would provide pass or fail. That means you have to provide what test case have passed, what test case have failed, which is called as a test result document, test results report, which will contain screenshots, captions, and verdicts, pass or fail, and you can put it in a PDF or document form. So that would be your test execution. Okay, so before execution, you have to ask the developer team to provide the code and infer them to deploy the code into the environment, and then only you can actually test it. Otherwise, you cannot test it without the code. So that would be your end of the test execution. So mainly you are going to get involved in test design stage and test execution stage. Okay, so then let me just finish it so that we can. Storage wise, the development team will store all their coding in Softbase, okay, either SVN or Git, wherever they are storing according to the project. And info team will deploy the code in particular environment, right? Test team will store in their test cases, test reports, test execution documents, and everything in a SharePoint or anywhere. It's totally project dependent. And defects will be provided or reported using the defect tracking application like Jira or QCRAL. Okay, so until this, I will give the homework. So these two homeworks are already given, right? So I'll give this one more. Okay. Now what you have to do is write your own test case like this in the Excel spreadsheet. Okay, don't worry, I'll share this with you, because this will be acting as your reference point. So I'll put this number 3 here, test scenario, let's say 3. So now you have to do the 3, and make sure in the tomorrow's lab session you show it to Russell, so he will verify it. Okay. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll stop here, because next thing is we are going to the levels of test execution, how many levels in detail. So today we have seen mainly the test design stage, how to write test cases, mainly how to write scenarios and how to elaborate them in test cases, right? Now there will be different levels of execution, not just one, and we will see these levels of execution tomorrow. Okay, so make sure you write all these homeworks by tomorrow. So I'll share it till here.
Nana, this recording, can we have access this recording?
Sorry, what is it?
The recording, the class recording, can we have access to this recording?
Oh, yeah, class recording, Asad will provide. Asad, can you provide the link for the recording too? Asad, are you on?
We need the link of recordings for the previous classes too, which we have missed.
Correct, correct. Yeah, that's what I'm asking. So there are four classes, right? So Asad, actually it is recording, but